If you're seeing some kind of dips in stock market, how can you predict whether the selling would continue and even accelerate in future? Or can this dip prove to be a great buying opportunity? And the answer to that is extremely simple. You look at VIX, but not the way that usually traders look at, right? What they do is they would look at what's happening in VIX in spot levels, right? Or at max, they would look at what's happening in VIX futures. But the VIX future that they usually look at is only 1 month out. So if I am seeing some kind of dips in, say, July, at max, they would look at only two data points, what's happening with VIX currently and what's happening with VIX for August futures. But add three more data points to your analysis and it'll give you a very meaningful insight on the current sell-off and what is it that you should be anticipating going forward from this sell-off scenario. And what you should be looking at is look at VIX futures for next 3 months as well. So apart from August month, also look for VIX futures in September, October, and November. And how can you predict whether this sell-off that you're seeing right now can continue or not? If any of these 3 months have seen their VIX spiking up by at least 15%, and I'm talking about day-to-day basis, right? And if you saw, let's say, VIX futures for September month to be at 20, and all of a sudden the VIX futures have spiked by 15%, and now you're seeing the VIX futures at 23, that means you should be alarmed. Because a spike above 15% means the markets are factoring in a lot of uncertainty in the near future. And that's when you should become very, very prudent about both your long positions as well as your short positions in the stock market, right? It doesn't mean that every time the VIX goes up that the market would only see the crash, right? Sometimes the VIX may crash the next day and you may see some kind of a recovery. So staying out of the market during these times is perhaps the best way to tread these uncertain times, right? So again, look at VIX futures, not just in the immediate next month, but also the 3 next months, and see if the spike is there for more than 15% or not. If the spike is there for more than 15%, it's a big red flag. Be very prudent. And if the spike is only, say, 2, 3, 4%, and you're seeing that, yes, there is a spike in the current month, in spot, as well as in the next futures, as well as the 3 months future out, but the spike is very nominal, say 3, 4, 5%, which is normal on a daily basis, right? Then it's a normal sell-off and do not read too much into it, but keep your eyes on the VIX futures on a consistent basis unless you see the VIX coming down, not only for spot, but also for your futures. That means it is a very good time to go bullish again. However, if you see the VIX continuing its upward journey, and at some time, over 2, 3, 4 days, you see that when you started looking at the futures, now the VIX is, say, 15, 20, 25% up from those levels, that is also a red flag, right? So sometimes you can see a spike within 1 day itself of 15%, or you may see 15 to 25% spike in 2 to 3 days. In both the scenarios, it's a big, big red flag. And if that's not happening, and if one of the months is actually showing a dip in VIX futures, but you're seeing a sell-off in the markets currently, it's a very good buying opportunity as well. So keep an eye out on VIX futures in at least 3 to 5 months out, and it will give you a very good insight about how the markets are pricing in futures uncertainty.